This is huge. OpenAI has released 2 new open source models, and these are proper large language models with 20 and 120 billion parameters. They are Apache 2 licensed, and that means you can run it, distribute it, fine-tune it, and even build things on top of them. I want to see what these models can do, how to run them locally on a laptop, and how to deploy them on the cloud. I'll leave links for everything that I mentioned down in the description, so check that for more information. These are frontier level models. They have chain of thought. They can reason about the problem step by step. They have 3 settings of reasoning effort: low, medium, and high. They can be fine-tuned, so you can build a new model on top of these foundation models. They have a mixture of expert architecture. They combine multiple trained experts in the same model. The big model has 128 experts, and the smaller one has 32 experts. Both have a token context window of 120k tokens. They support function calling. You can plug in a browser to run searches, and you can run Python code and return structured outputs. The main limitation is English. Both models have been trained mainly on an English dataset. I have tested it in other languages and it works pretty well despite this. And they have been trained especially for coding and STEM and science. Here in the artificial benchmark page, we can compare this model against other commercial and open source models. We can see the intelligence, speed, and price. So the bigger model is not as intelligent as the just released GPT-5. In fact, it's near the end of the curve. It's more or less on par with DeepSeek's R1. But when we consider speed, the bigger model is only second to Gemini, so it's a very fast model, and it's considerably faster than GPT-5. What closes the deal is price. The big model is slightly better and cheaper than Llama 3, and it's several orders of magnitude cheaper than the other frontier models. Online is the easiest way to try a model. There is nothing to manage, it's very cost effective. The downside is that you're sending your data to a third party, so you shouldn't do anything sensitive unless you really trust the platform. GPTOSS.com is run by OpenAI, and it lets us test both models. We can select the reasoning effort, and we don't even need to sign in to use these models. If we press the download button, we actually get commands to download and run these models using Hugging Face, OLlama, and LM Studio. Speaking of Hugging Face, the official site to download the weights is huggingface.co, and here we can get all the weights and load all the original models and the models that have been fine-tuned by different users. Another website that offers fast access to this model is Cerebras. We need to create an account, but once logged in, we can try the models online for free. Cerebras also offers API keys to access these models using endpoints programmatically. If we want to integrate our application, endpoints are the easiest way to interact with the models. In OpenRouter, we can find many providers for the GPT OSS 20V and for the GPT OSS 120V. If we go to Grok, we can also try the model online on the playground or create an API key to make API calls. Online services are very convenient, but they don't offer the same level of control or privacy as running your own large language model on your computer. The small model is meant to run on laptops and desktops. As long as we have 16 GB of RAM, we should be able to run the model. You can also get pretty good performance on an Apple machine with an M3 Max chip and 32 GB of RAM. On desktops, an NVIDIA RTX 50 series is a good entry point GPU to run the smaller model. So to run these models on our desktops, we have several options. LM Studio is a desktop application, runs on Windows, Linux, and macOS. It's not open source, but it's one of my favorites. It's easy to use. It has 3 settings for users, power users, and developers. To get started, we install LM Studio. Be sure you are using the latest version. Then here we go models near the top, type GPT-OSS and press search. Be sure to choose the 4-bit version. It says MXFP4. This is the original release by OpenAI. We select the model from the top, and once it's loaded, we can start using it. It's running the model locally, and no data is going to the cloud. OLlama provides a simple UI to run the GPT-OSS models. First, we have to download the binary from OLlama.com. We have Windows, Linux, and macOS versions. This is the OLlama window. As long as we keep Turbo and Search disabled, we can run the model completely offline. vLLM is a Python application to run large language models. To use vLLM, we must first install UV, which is a package manager for Python. Once we have that, we can use the quick start commands in the vLLM docs. We start a chat session with vLLM serve and select the model. This will download the model if it's not downloaded yet. Then we have Llama.cpp. This is a very popular software to run LLMs. So to install Llama.cpp, we go to the GitHub repository, pick our system, and then we need to manually download the model from Hugging Face. In the case of Llama.cpp, we need the GGUF format, so we need to download a model that's formatted in this format. We can pick the models using the Hugging Face filters and search for GPT-OSS 16 versions. This is the original 4-bit version. The name is wrong, it's mislabeled. And you can use the Qt version if you have 16 GB of RAM. Once downloaded, we open a new terminal, go to the folder where we have the model and run Llama CLI, and we put the name of the GGUF files. If you don't have the hardware or you have higher requirements, maybe you need to serve a lot of users, the most cost-effective options are to rent GPU-powered servers. These are shared instances for the most part, but should be okay for most use cases. We can get shared instances in RunPod, Jarvis Labs, or the NVIDIA Cloud. In some industries like banking or health, a shared instance might not be viable because we have data privacy concerns. And in those cases, the only option is to run everything in-house. And we have two options. Either we buy hardware or rent infrastructure. How much would it cost to run the biggest model in our own cloud machine? Well, we need pretty powerful hardware. For a data center grade setup, OpenAI recommends using an H100. Or we can use a Blackwell RTX 6000, which is a consumer-grade GPU. A dedicated virtual machine can provide the right balance of convenience, privacy, and cost. On Google Cloud or AWS, an H100 GPU-equipped server can cost between $9,000 and $11,000 per month, and a dedicated RTX 6000 GPU machine on Linux can go up to $4,000 per month. So there you have it. OpenAI's first truly open source large language models. Now, I normally don't trust a lot of the benchmark. I prefer to use the models myself. I started using it a few days ago, and I'm very curious, have you tried these models? If you are trying them, how are you finding them compared to other open source LLMs or ChatGPT? If you have any experience or interesting stories, please leave a comment and let me know. I'm very curious. Don't forget to check all the resources in the description. And if you found this video interesting or helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell because there's plenty more videos coming soon. Thank you for watching and see you on the next one.